Levier Fine Writing Instruments and Levier Casting Products are proud to present the turning and assembly process of a European style pen using one of Levier Casting Products. Safety is priority number one. It is important to use ears and eye protection, or a complete face shield with a respirator, to avoid any injuries during the use of the lathe. Long sleeves and gloves are not recommended in front of the lathe. If you follow these safety guidelines, you will minimize the possibility of an accident. Be sure to use skin-tight gloves, and the sleeves have to be protected inside the gloves. Sharpened tools are a must for any turning project. We have made a complete library on how to sharpen your tools, and these videos are available here in YouTube. Check our username, Levier 2011. There are many ways to sharpen your tools. In our case, we have selected a low-speed water-cooled grinder in combination with several jigs to accommodate each particular tool. After grinding, we use the honing wheel to increase the life of the cutting edge. A low-speed water-cooled grinder provides a lot of advantages. There are no sparks, the tool will never be hot, so this will not affect the integrity of the metal, and better yet, there is no dust in our working environment. There's only one tool that we use a hand sharpening, and that is the Spindle Master. Organization is a must in any working environment. Knowing where your tools, components, and instructions are located will minimize the setup time, and productivity will be implemented. Following the instructions provided with your pen kit, we're going to select the drill bits and bushings required for this project. We are also going to need a drill or a mill to clean the edges of our blanks after drilling and gluing. Levier Casting Products. Our new line of casting products are made with worldwide quality and state-of-the-art equipment. If you would like more information about our casting products, feel free to send us an email and we will provide you with the inventory and quantities that we have. We can also make a custom-made casting according to your specifications. Now that we have selected our casting and the pen kit that we are going to use, it is now time to drill and glue the tubes inside the blanks. It is important to put a witness mark so we can align the grain or the pattern of the colors in our acrylic casting. The first tool that we are going to use is the roughing gouge. The roughing gouge is a very aggressive tool that will help us achieve a cylindrical shape in our squared blanks. As we can see in this series of cuts, we are being very aggressive with the pen blank. we can see the high performance of our acrylics in combination with an extreme sharp tool. We can see that shavings are coming out, and the appearance of our blank is almost ready for the final assembly. After we have achieved the cylinder, it is now time to move to the skewer. The skewer is a very versatile tool. It will help us define our project, and at the same time will provide a very good finish without applying any sanding or any polish. We are going to use the skewer in two positions. We are going to cut with a long point facing up and a long point facing down. Practice is required to master the use of the skewer. But as we can see here, the results that we can achieve are just awesome. The spindle master is an alternative tool instead of using the skewer. It is a tool that is easy to control, and the definition of our designs are very well achieved. As we can see in these cuts, the end result is not as clean as the skewer, but we can make it better if we change the position of our cuts. At the same time, it is important to see the shavings that are coming out during these cuts. Once again, a high sharpened pen with a world-class quality pen blank. We have now a defined project, but the final shape has not been achieved. What we are going to do next is using the parting tool to make a recess or a pocket to accommodate a metal ring that is part of the pen kit. After achieving that pocket, we are going to match the diameter of this ring to the diameters of our pen project. It is important to use quality control to assure the ergonomics and the fit of the pen. Progressive wet sanding is needed for any acrylic project. We're going to use 120 to 2000 grit sandpaper. After the sandpaper, we're going to use the plastic polish. The plastic polish will eliminate any micro marks left from the sanding process and will increase the shine in our project. Let's take a moment and see the end result by applying the plastic polish and the high shine that we are going to achieve. We are keeping a left and right movement to avoid the overheat of our pen blank during the polishing. But as we can see here, it is an extreme or high shine pen.